my story begins during the last war. It had been another long day in the factory, and I was ready for home and a bite to eat. My hatred for the enemy and the evils of war were far from my mind. Even the familiar old sound of the siren didn't incite me to panic. Too many times during that week I'd panicked and run to my Anderson's shelter, only to discover it was another false alarm. It seemed such a beautiful evening, so quiet and still. Why should anyone want to spoil my peace? There was no reason to think tonight would be any different from any other. Thank you.
Morning, nurse.
Morning, doctor.
Any trouble in the night?
No, everything's gone reasonably well, apart from a slight problem with Mrs. Brown's temperature.
Very good. Very good, nurse. May I have a word with you in the office before you continue your duty?
Yes, doctor.
Have a seat, nurse.
Thank you.
What I'd like to say, nurse, is our coma patient, we're having him moved to St. Clair's next Monday. Does that upset you, nurse?
I suppose I've become very attached to Derek. He's no one else since his aunt died.
Yes, all those visits that she made for the past 40 years, just hoping for some kind of miracle.
If only he were to regain consciousness. He has a home to go to, you know. His aunt left it to him in her will.
Well, nurse, we'll pass this over to the almoner. I've quite a bit to do now, so you can carry on with your duties. Thank you.
Don't know when, but I know we'll meet again some sunny day. Keep smiling through, just like you always do, till the blue skies drive the dark clouds far away.
Doctor!
What is it, nurse? I'm coming.
Oh, will you please say hello to the folks that I know? Tell them I won't be long. They'll be happy to know that as you saw me go, I was singing this song. We meet again.
I switched on the radio. Next thing I noticed, some eye movement. What do you think, Doctor?
Well, nurse, I think this is the miracle you've been waiting for. Well, Derek, you're leaving us now.
Thanks for everything, Doctor. You've been so kind.
You'll find quite a few changes when you get outside. But good luck to you.
I'll take him home now, Doctor.
Brave new world. I wonder what you hold in store for me this time. If we stop the car and let me have a look around. It seems such a beautiful day. I'd like to make the most of it. park hasn't changed, Jean. Do you know my favourite seat's still there? My, the seemingly endless days that Christine and I sat there. I wonder whatever became of her. House, will you let me go in on my own? I feel that the sooner I find some kind of routine, the quicker I'll begin to settle. Suppose people who have seen a general progression in technology take it all for granted. Now I can see things in a better perspective. I find life now so hurried, so impatient. People wanting too many materialistic things out of life. I know we shouldn't stand in the way of progress, but also we should not forget all the simple pleasures in life, all the world's beauty, the closeness of our loved ones. But who would listen to me, a man unconscious, for 40 years? It's a sign of the times, I suppose, that man with all his progress still cannot control his greed and his longing for power. Acting out a role for some superior being somewhere? Or are we truly in control of our own destiny? Who can we really trust to guide us through this very difficult period of mankind's journey in time? I suppose it's ironic that with all our power to heal, to cure, and our power to build a better world, we should choose to divert this technology towards ruining our ideal and destroy what we are supposedly protecting.